हेलो फ्रेंड्स, गुड मॉर्निंग वन एंड ऑल. इन यस्टरडेज़ लेक्चर वी हैव सीन द डिफरेंट रेजिस्टिंग फोर्सेस ऑन द कन्वेयर बेल्ट. ओके, इन टुडेज़ लेक्चर वी विल गोइंग ऑन द न्यूमेरिकल. बिफोर गोइंग ऑन दैट, सी व्हाट वी हैव सीन इन द यस्टरडेज़ लेक्चर. वी हैव फाइंड आउट लोड रेजिस्टेंस ड्यू टू द लिफ्टिंग ऑफ मटेरियल. इट इज़ डिनोटेड बाय द FM. Then frictional resistance due to the idler. Third is a frictional resistance at pulley. Then fourth is a resistance at loading station. Fifth is a frictional resistance at unloading station and frictional resistance at cleaning station. Each and everything we have seen in the yesterday's lecture. Okay, today's lecture we will see the numerical. Okay, first numerical. See what is the given in the problem statement. You have to write that. First is a triple ply belt conveyor is required to transport 2 ton of iron over per hour through a distance of 1000 meter. Okay, and height of 300 meter. Means what is the given data? A triple ply is given. Okay, means this value is given for the ZP. Plies are given, number of plies. Okay, number of plies is denoted by the ZP. Okay, this value is a 3 is there, that's why ZP is equal to 3. And again LH is equal to given 1000 meter, and height is given 300 meter. Okay, the permissible belt speed is 90 meter per mm. Okay, permissible speed is given, means V value is given. The per mm is given. You have to convert into the meter per second. 90 divided by 60, you will get this value in meter per second. If the mass density of iron ore is 2.5 ton per cubic meter, mass density is denoted by the capital M. This is given. Mass density, rho is denoted by the mass density. 2.5 ton. Okay, what is the 1 ton value? 10^3 kg. Okay, convert into the kg per meter cube. Rho is equal to 2.5 × 10^3. Determine, we want to calculate the belt width, means capital B, diameter of the drive pulley. We want to calculate the DI value, the reduction ratio of the gear reducer. If electric motor speed is 1440 rpm, use the following data. That flowability factor K and belt inclination angle is given, alpha. This two value is given. Also standard belt width we want to choose. Okay, then you have to choose this standard belt width. Okay, if you are getting the suppose 350 value, then you have to choose the 400. If you are getting the 400 and above value, in between that 400 and 450, then you should choose the 450 is there. Then material factor for plies, for capron material is given. Belt K1 is equal to 2, and belt tension and arc of contact, means factor K2 is given 80. This is the given data. This motor speed N is equal to 1440. Then see how to solve the given numerical. Yesterday we have seen some formulas. With the help of that formula, we want to solve this numerical. First, how to calculate the belt width? Firstly, you have given the belt inclination alpha. This is your belt. This is the horizontal length of the belt, and height is given. In between, they are making the angle alpha. Okay, this angle we want to calculate. You know that tan alpha is equal to opposite side divided by what? Adjacent side. H divided by LH. You know the trigonometry. You can calculate the alpha value with the help of using this trigonometry. This H height is given 300 and LH is given 1000 meter. You will get the 16.7 degree. Then see from given data, here is a 16.7 degree. Check this table, where is the 16 degree? In between 16 degree and 20 degree. Okay, what is the value of flowability factor K? 2.5 × 10^-4. This is the value
K choose from the given table. Okay, then belt width, you know that this belt is horizontal. Okay, here if you have considered the inclined belt, a triple conveyor required, they have given the horizontal distance 1000 meter. Okay, then see, you know there are two horizontal and inclined belt is there. We'll calculate for the horizontal. M is equal to rho into Q is there. Again, what is the rho into K into 0.9B minus 0.05 square phi? We have seen this formula. Put all the value in this formula. Then you will get the B value is a 910.8 mm. But here standard width of the belt is given. We have the 910 is there. Check that. Here is a 900. After that, we will get the 910. That's why you have to choose the 1000. The standard belt size is a 1000 mm. Choose from that. Okay. Then diameter of the drive pulley. You know how to calculate the diameter of the drive pulley. K1, K2 into ZP. Number of plies are given 3. K1 value is given 2. K2 value is given 80. You will get the D diameter of the drive pulley is equal to 480 mm. And reduction ratio of the gear reducer, you know the formula for that, G or P is equal to pi dN divided by 60. We want to calculate that value. N is equal to what? If you have convert, 60V divided by pi d is there. Okay. Since the speed drive pulley is N is equal to 60V divided by pi d, put the value, you will get the N is equal to 59.7 RPM. Okay. Reduction ratio, how to calculate? You have given the motor speed. Okay. Motor speed divided by the speed of the drive pulley. With the help of that, you can calculate the reduction ratio. Okay, G is equal to small n divided by capital N. Small n is given. Motor speed is given 1440 divided by this capital N is, we have calculated 59.7. V is equal to pi dN divided by 60. We know that formula. Okay. With the help of that, we have calculated the capital N. Means we have calculated the speed of the drive pulley. Okay. Then you will get the gear ratio is 24.13. In MCQ, you will get the small questions. You have given the small N value, capital N value. Or you have given the only that V value. Okay. And D value. With the help of that, you can calculate the capital N value. Okay. This type of numerical will ask. Then second, see for the inclined. We have seen the horizontal bend. Then second numerical we'll see on the inclined belt. Okay, what is the first problem statement? An inclined belt conveyor is for the loading the material oral in a ship. The belt inclination is 20 degree. Here you have given the direct angle of the belt inclination is 20 degrees there. For which the flowability factor K is 2.5 into 10 raised to minus 4. Last numerical we have given the table alpha and K, related value of K. Okay, if angle is given 20 degree, then value is 2.5 into 10 raised to minus 4. The belt width is a 1000 mm, capital B is given. We'll convert into the meter, then you will get the 1 meter. While belt speed is at 2 meter per second, as it is, V is given. If the specific weight of the mineral ore is 16,000 newton per meter cube, okay, mineral specific weight is given, W value is given, okay, 16,000 newton per meter cube. Determine the capacity of the conveyor. We want to calculate the Q value. Determine the Q value. Then how to calculate? K is equal to 2.5 into 10 raised to minus 4. V is equal to 2 meter per second given. B is equal to 1000 mm means 1 meter is given. W is given 16,000 newton per meter cube. You know the formula or relation how to calculate the rho value. Here we required the rho value. Right. Then how to calculate that? You know W divided by G or rho into G is equal to specific weight. Okay. With the help of that, you can calculate the rho you will get the 1630.99 kg per meter cube. Then you have to calculate the volumetric capacity of the conveyor because of inclined belt. Okay, you know the formula. Q is equal to what? K into 0.9b minus 0.05 square into P is there. Put all the value in that equation. Then you will get the value is 3.6125 into 10 raised to minus 4 meter cube per second. Okay. If you want to convert this answer into meter cube per hour, okay, here is a meter cube per second. Then multiply by 60 into 60 what? 3600. Then you have to multiply by 3600 to this answer. Then you will get the coming answer in meter cube per hour. Q is equal to, you will get the 1.3005. Remember that when we want to use the horizontal belt conveyor formula and when we want to use the inclined belt conveyor formula, there are mentioned in the problem statement. Once you have got the Q, then you have to calculate the mass capacity of the conveyor. Here determine the capacity of the conveyor. And how to calculate that? M is equal to rho into Q. Rho is known, Q is known. Put this value in that equation, you will get the M is equal to 2121.1 kg per hour. Okay.
Then next numerical. See, the following data refers to the horizontal belt conveyor for carrying bulk material. Capacity of the conveyor means which value is given? M is given, capital M, 250 metric ton per hour. Check that. M is given 250. Here 250 metric ton is given per hour. Belt speed is given 1.5 meter per second. Width of the belt is given 1200 mm. Belt mass per unit length, that value, belt mass per unit length is given 18.6 kg per meter. Mass of each carrying run idler and mass of each return idler is given. Pitch of carrying run idler, pitch of return idler is given. Frictional factor of idlers, snub factor of snub pulley, snub factor for the drive and tail pulley diameters. Means each and everything you have given, what we want to calculate. Assume that the bulk material is carried over a length of 300 meter and neglecting the resistance at the loading station. Determine, okay, length is given, carried over the length 300 meter, the reduction ratio of the gearbox, again we want to calculate, we know the how to calculate the last numerical we have seen, reduction ratio of the gearbox, the power required to drive the belt, we want to calculate the power required to drive that belt. Then how to calculate? See, here is a drive pulley is given and tail pulley is given. Okay, this is in given data. This figure is given in given data. This distance in between the snub pulley is given, length of snub pulley, 250 meter, and distance between drive pulley to tail pulley, that is given 300 meter. Here is a one cleaner as shown in figure. There is a two snub pulley. There are four return idlers and here is a eight carrying idler are shown. Then how to calculate that? See, we'll consider that here is a hooper, then they are connected to the belt. Here is a drive pulley, then tail pulley is there as it is. But before going on that, we want to check where is the starting point and where is the final point. Okay, or we can say the initial point. And yesterday we have seen, right, resistance of loading station. There we have seen, we want to find out the final and initial points. Okay, we'll consider, first give the name of that pulley. See, here is a, for the first snub pulley I will give the P1, second snub pulley P2, then here is a tail pulley P3, and here is a drive pulley is a P4. This name are given. Okay. Then see, I will give the starting point of the snub pulley is a 1. And here where the belt is connected to that snub pulley, the center, This is the second point, means initial and final point. Then again second snap pulley P2, 3 point and 4 point. Here I will give the only 1 point for the tail pulley, 5 point. Then after that here where this is the disconnect, we'll give the point number 6. And last is a point number 7. This is near to the drive pulley. And forces, we want to the calculate that frictional force, F is there. Okay, I have considered that point. This is the given data, N is equal to 1440 RPM. V is given 1.5 meter per second. We know the how to calculate the gear ratio. Okay, or reduction ratio of the gear reducer. G is equal to small n divided by capital N. Already we have seen. Okay, you know the V formula, pi dn divided by 60. With the help of that formula, you can calculate the reduction ratio of the gear reducer, G value. Number of carrying and return idlers also given. Here shown the only in that figure 4, but they have given here number of return idler and number of carrying idler. Both values are given. This values, see, number of carrying and return idler for length is given, L1, 250 meter, okay, length is given, and L2 is given, sorry, here I have written L1, L2 is there, L2 is 300 meter, okay, and TC is nothing but yesterday we have seen pitch of the carrying run idler. Pitch of the carrying run idler is given 1 meter and pitch of the return run idler is given 2 meter. Okay. Then after that, one by one thing we want to calculate. First, we want to calculate the number of return run idler. How many idlers are given? Okay. How to calculate that? They are not given in the problem statement. How many idlers are given? Carrying idler and return idler. Then how to calculate that number of return run idler, ZR, we want to calculate. We know the formula, you should remember, TR is equal to L1 divided by ZR plus 1. Okay, return run, we are using the suffix R. Okay, TR is the pitch of the return run idler. What is the ZR? We have seen number of return run idler plus 1. TR is given 2, then L1 is given 250, ZR is given, we want to calculate plus 1, ZR you will get the 124, means number of return run idlers are used 124. Similar way we want to calculate the number of carrying run idlers, L2 divided by ZC plus 1 is there, okay, TC is given 1, then 300 divided by ZC plus 1, you will get the ZC is equal to 299. First two value we required to find out what is the number of carrying run idler and what is the number of return run idler. Once you have calculated, then belt tension along the conveyor belt. We want to find out first at initial point I or Fi is equal to F slack. Okay, here is the initial point. We are consider this I is the initial point where the belt is connected. Okay, this is known as F slack side, okay, is equal to F slack. At point one, how to calculate, this is the FCL. Yesterday we have seen that, what is the FCL, anybody? Frictional resistance at cleaning station. Why we require that FCL? Because we are going to this direction, anti-clockwise direction, this is moving. Okay, because here is a scrub are used or cleaning device are used. This is the rotary brush type. Yesterday we have seen rotary brush type is, then FCL is equal to 100B is there. 100B is there. Okay, they have given 100B is there. Then how to calculate the F1 is equal to Fi plus FCL. F1 is equal to Fi plus, where is our F1? This is the F1, 1 point. Okay, behind that FI and this is the rotary brush type cleaning device is added. That's why slack side force plus that cleaning device, okay, force. we want to the calculate, you will get the F1 value. You will get the F1 value. Fi plus FCL. Put that again. What is the Fi? F slacks plus 100 B is there. 100 B is there. Okay. Then we know the formula. F slack plus 100 into 1. What is the width of the belt? 1 meter is there. Okay, then you will get the F1 is equal to F slacks plus 100 Newton. At point 2, check that. Where is the point 2? There is, we want to the use that frictional resistance at pulley. Because belt is touched to that, exactly touch, means second point is the frictional resistance at pulley, FP. Okay, we want to the calculate for the second point. FP is equal to, we know the epsilon, F1.
Epsilon, F1.
Then how to calculate the epsilon, that F1?
You know the value of that is given 0.03 in the given data. You have to check. Then you have to calculate F2 is equal to F1 value plus FPL.
This is the frictional resistance at the pulley. Then put the value F1 plus epsilon P1 into F1. Then take the common F1. You will get the 1 plus epsilon P1 F1. Put the value. You will get the F2 is equal to 1.03 F slacks plus 103. Then next point. When you're going to the forward direction, then check that the this is the summation of the behind forces. Means when you calculate the F3, check that. Where is the F3? F3 is the second snub pulley is there. Okay. That point is a MI. What is the MI we have seen yesterday? Mass of each idler. We want to the consider a mass of each idler. There is a 25 kg is given. FC. In that FC we have seen how to calculate that. FC, 0.02 is given. Okay, FC is nothing but the friction factor. Yesterday we have seen how to calculate that friction factor. You have given the grade or service, light, moderate, heavy, serve. Okay, there is given for the straight idler and trap idler. That both value are different. You have given the 0.02, means moderate is given. Indoors, normal, humidity, abrasive dust is given. Service condition for that 0.02 value. L1 is 250 meter. MB is nothing but the mass of the belt per unit length is given. And ZR is the number of return run idler. You have to choose only the return run idler. When you going the upward direction, then we want to choose the ZC, number of carrying run idler. Okay, then F2 plus FRR. We know the FRR means what? Frictional resistance due to the return run idler. Use the formula FC into bracket MB plus MI ZR divided by L1 is there. Okay. L1 is there into GL1 is there. Then you have to, or we can say the LR is there. Put all the value, then you will get the F3 is equal to 1.03 F slacks plus 162.355 Newton. Then next point at point 4, again epsilon for the P2, you will get the 0.03. Put the value F4 is equal to F3 plus FP2. Okay, then F3 plus epsilon P2, F3 is equal to, you will get the, take the common F3. Similar way you have to calculate the F4 value. Again at 0.5, check that, at 0.5, where is the 0.5? This is the 0.5 at the tail pulley, okay. Again check in the 0.5, again epsilon P3 is there, P3, we are consider the pulley number 3. This value is a 0.06, okay. F plus FP3, what is the value of FP3? Again epsilon P3 into F4. Take F4 common, again put the value, you will get the F5 value. Then at 0.6, here we are going to the carrying idlers. F6 at 0.6, check that, this is the VI. VI, what is the VI? Yesterday we have seen in that resistance at loading station. Okay, what is the VI? VI is the initial speed of the belt, and or we can say the component of incoming material velocity along the belt line. This is nothing but the V. V also same, the belt speed, 1.5 meter per second. Then you can calculate the M value. M is equal to, we know the formula, yesterday we have seen, M is equal to what? M is equal to mm into V. Mm into V. This value is given, 250 into 10 raised to 3 divided by 3600. Then F6 is equal to F5 plus FL. F5 plus FL. Again, what is the FL? FL is nothing but the resistance at loading station. Here is a 6 number point. Okay, because we are coming to the loading station. This material is coming through the hopper on the belt. Here is a 6 number point. That's why we want to consider resistance at loading. Okay, this FL value in point number 6. Okay, F5 plus M into V minus VI. Yesterday we have seen that formula. Mass flow rate into V minus VI. Okay, you have to put the all the value in that equation. F5 we have calculated this value, plus this value is a M is equal to 69.44, and this value we will get the 0. Okay, then you will get this same answer for the F5 and F6. Then at point 7, mm is equal to, I have told this, mm is equal to m by v, mb is equal to 18.6, and zc, carrying idler. Here is a, we are use only the carrying run idler, number of carrying run idler. Then see, put the value and calculate the EFC value. Then this value are given. Okay, we want to calculate the F7. F7 is equal to FC plus FCR. Okay, FCR again, what is the, this value is, we know that FC is there. Okay, we want to use that formula. Here we know the FC is equal to, for carrying run idler, FCR is nothing but the what? Frictional resistance due to the carrying run idler. We know that FCR is equal to FC into bracket MM plus MB plus MI ZC divided by L2 into G into L2. Put all this value and find out F7 value. Then at final point F, there again we'll get some frictional resistance at pulley. Where we'll get the pulley? There we'll get the frictional resistance. Check that. On this pulley, 7 number point. Then here is a 2 number. Then 4 number is there. Okay. Then you have to use the epsilon long. Okay. This formula. Fp is equal to epsilon. F1 is there. Means F at point 7 you will get, at final point F we want to calculate. F is equal to epsilon P4. This value is given, 0.06. Then we want to calculate that tight side, force on the tight side. How to get? F7 plus FP4. FP4 we have given the pulley number 4. This is the drive number, drive pulley. F7 plus epsilon P4 into F7. Take the F7 is common, put the value, you will get the F tight value. Then ratio of the effective belt tension on the drive. How to calculate that? F tight divided by F slack pulley. Okay, you know that, this, remember that formula. Mu is given. This is the 0.4 is given, frictional factor. Theta is equal to 200 into pi divided by 180. You know how to calculate in the radian, pi divided by 180. 200 is given, then multiply by pi by 180, you will get answer in radian. Then F tight divided by F slack is nothing but the e raised to mu theta. Remember this formula. What is the mu? This is the coefficient of friction between the drive pulley and belt. Okay, coefficient of friction in between the drive pulley and belt. And theta, what is the theta? Yesterday we have seen angle of lap on the drive pulley. Angle of lap on the drive pulley, that theta. Put the value and find out the F tight divided by F slack. Then next is we want to find out the power. Okay, you will get the F tight and F slack value with the help of that equation. Okay, F tight is equal to F slack. You will get the 4.04 slack is there, F slack. Okay, then put this value 0.04 F slack is equal to, we have already calculated that value. Put this value, you will get the F slack and F tight value. Then how to calculate the power required on drive pulley? This is the output power. PO is equal to F tight minus F slack divided by 1000 into V is there. V is nothing but the belt speed is there. This is given, the 1.5 meter per second is given. Okay. You have to check that value, put each value in that equation, you will get the output power. Then how to calculate the input power to the belt conveyor? We know that they have given the efficiency. Okay, efficiency of the drive is given. Then efficiency is equal to, we know, the output power divided by input power. Then you will get the input power. Power rating of the standard electric motor. This is the, we have the 13.86 kilometer watt. We choose the 15 kilowatt. This is the standard. Okay, all of you getting? Okay, this type of numerical will ask for the 18 marks in the theory examination, but you will get the MCQ question. That's why remember the formulae. Okay, how to calculate each and every value? You should remember that 6 formulae. Okay, today we'll stop here. Next lecture, we'll start the unit number 4. Okay. Thank you.